Hello everyone, this is my Jonway Raptor scooter, which I have been riding for about a year and a half, and I decided to make a review video for it and explain what are the ins and outs of this scooter. I purchased this scooter back on March 2015, brand new, from Cruze Scooters in Brookline, Massachusetts. So CruzeScooters.com, and I had no affiliation with Cruze Scooters. At that time I had just started working in Brookline area, and I needed a commuter scooter for getting there because the bus I was taking was just taking way too long. It's only 6 miles, but in Boston traffic in the morning it can take up to, you know, an hour and a half getting there from home. So I got this brand new, and it has been serving me very well. People say that Chinese scooters and motorcycles are not good. Well, there are some truth to it, but if you compare it to Japanese scooters, these Chinese scooters are not on par in terms of quality. But again, you are paying only a fraction. So I got this, including the registration, close to $1,200 brand new. And because it was 49.5cc here in Massachusetts, you don't have to register it as a motorcycle, it's registered as a moped. And the big advantage for me was that I can go in bike lanes, and also when the traffic is stopped, I can go on the right side of the cars. So it was saving me a lot of time when I was commuting to that area from home and back. It was only taking 25-30 minutes instead of an hour and 15 minutes, up to an hour and a half. So one thing I should say is I have been taking good care of this scooter. So I have been always changing the oil, engine oil as well as the gear oil on time. So I've been, after the initial break-in of the engine, which during which I just used just regular scooter oil, I did the first oil change at the service of Cruze Scooters at 200 miles and the second one at 700 miles. After that I start changing my own oil, and I've been using this oil, Shell Rotella T6 synthetic heavy-duty diesel oil, 5W-40. And after reading a lot of articles and forums online, I decided this oil is good for motorcycles as well as scooters. And I've been using it also on my Honda CBR motorcycle, and it has been great. I never had any issues. And the engine oil stays the same in terms of amount, so it doesn't burn or anything, and it doesn't change color as much as the conventional oils. And for the gear oil, I have been using Mobil 1 synthetic gear lubricant LS 75W-90. I did something else as well, so I have been adding Marvel Mystery Oil to my gas on every tank fill. So I have been using about 11 milliliters, which is this amount, so I always carry it in that little glove compartment. And whenever I am adding gas, it usually takes about 1 gallon. I've been adding that 11 milliliters of the Marvel Mystery Oil to the gas. And the reason is I've been reading on all online forums, and people have been giving very good comments about Marvel Mystery Oil cleaning up the engine as well as the carb. And for those times when you are storing your scooter over the winter, I heard that Marvel Mystery Oil is stabilizing the gasoline very well. Anyway, let's get back to the Raptor. So the model of the scooter is YY50QT-30. But you may be able to find it in under different names as well, under different codes as well. This is from Jonway. And right now it's about almost 4,000 miles on it after about 18 months of use. Almost daily use, you know, 5 times a week probably for my commute. It's almost 4,000 miles. The tires are 12 inches. Compared to the other scooters, smaller scooters. By the way, this is my son's Jonway Agility, which I got for $150 on Craigslist. It wasn't working, but I spent another $100 just to change the belt, and the clutch was broken. The real clutch pulley was broken. So I spent about a little bit of elbow grease and $100, and also replaced the carb. Everything is so inexpensive on eBay, or you can't even find things on Amazon. And it's running great. This is also Jonway. It's a YY50QT-6. Just compare the size of the tire. These are 10-inch tires and wheels. And my Raptor has much larger tires, they're 12-inch. So that 12-inch tires gives the Raptor a feeling of almost riding like a motorcycle, small motorcycle. So it's very stable, it's not squirrely at all. Whenever I might ride my Raptor and then go to Agility, I have trouble with Agility going, especially into corners. It doesn't want to lean like this one. These tires are the standard tires that came on it, just Chinese tires. They have been very good on dry asphalt, but I had to be very careful on those white lines and pedestrian walkways, the painted sections, which can be very slippery when wet. So a few times the back slided a little bit and then I scared myself. So you have to be very careful if you have one of these. So I had done some modification on this scooter. The first thing I did was at around 750 miles once the engine braking was done, I added a high performance CDI and coil. Some people also call it governor. So CDI is the device that sends the electricity to the spark plug for ignition of the air fuel mixture. And by changing that, so before that it was only topping out at 30 miles an hour, because that's the requirement for it to be registered as a moped. So I just switched that by buying it, you know, a CDI, high performance CDI, as well as a high performance coil from Cruze Scooters. And then I had my first problem about 300 miles later. So the CDI box only lasted 300 miles and I got my first breakdown, and I ended up pushing the scooter about 4 or 5 miles home. And I realized it was just a CDI, so I ordered one from eBay. In this case, it was a Scorpion product from O2 Star Rider. That's the seller's name, Scorpion products. And came in, I installed it, it just started working again and never did not cause any problems until now. So that's been working very well. And then at around 1,400 miles, I installed a big bore kit. So the engine size got from about 49 cc to 88 cc. That big bore kit was sold as a 105 cc kit, but if you calculate the displacement from bore and stroke, it turns out it's about only 88 cc's. So it's a 52 millimeters bore instead of, I think the original is 41.5. And it gave me quite a bit of torque. And during that installation of the kit, I also installed an A9 racing cam and 20 millimeter carb. And later I changed the variator weights. The variator is behind this box here. And it just adjusts what RPM it is rotating at, this, giving power to the back, to the clutch. And I changed the variator and the waist to 8 grams from it, the original was 5 grams. And I recently changed it back to 6.5 grams because it was not revving high enough at the traffic lights, you know, starting up. So I wanted to be able to catch up with the cars a little better. So I changed 6.5 gram weight and installed a performance variator from, again, Scorpion products. I've been very happy with Scorpion products on eBay. So their products are, I think, a little higher quality than the no-name brands. The second time I got stranded was when the clutch pulley, the rear clutch pulley, which is again inside that box on the back, it broke. It was making some strange sounds and it suddenly broke and also shredded the belt. And again, that's my fault, not the fault. I cannot say that it's the scooter's fault because because of the big bore kit, that pulley and the belt was overworking. I had more torque, I was going at faster speeds. So I installed a new racing clutch and Gates PowerLink CVT belt. And I haven't had any issues since. It has been about 700 miles now on those. I also tried installing a performance exhaust. Again, I bought it from Scorpion Products. And it wasn't a direct fit. So you can see that I had to cut these tabs over here. And still it was a little under stress when I had to connect it to the exhaust and just attach it in place of the original one. It did not give I didn't feel any performance increase, and also it made it very loud, so I changed it back to the original exhaust, which I think looks and sounds fine to me. I like my Raptor in its current setup. It came with the standard front and rear disc brakes, which is a big plus. The rear has disc brakes as well, as you can see. And the stopping power is pretty good. It's nothing compared to my CBR, but you don't want the brakes to be acting too quickly on a scooter, especially if you are learning. You want a smooth application, not a really sharp braking point. The only issue with the brakes is when you are coming to a stop, you feel some pulsing on both front and rear brakes, but it's minor, it's barely noticeable. And probably what I will do in the future is start by changing the brake pads. And if that does not solve the problem, the discs themselves, they may be a little warped, but it does not affect the performance, so the stopping power is pretty good. And I opened up the under the seat compartment. It is quite nice, big. It does not fit full face helmet, but a half face will fit fine. I keep here my different kinds of gas treatments, and this is another gas treatment I use on every tank fill. It's Formula X2. This is for if you are planning to leave your bike sitting for a long time. It kind of absorbs the water so that it does not affect your carburetors at the end of your storage time. And here I also have my toolbox and rain gear. I keep some of the supplies under the seat. This scooter came also with the rear storage compartment, which I took off because I wasn't using it. So these are the holes from that one. But it had a nice large storage compartment on the back, color matched, mostly white with red accents. But I wasn't using it, and so I took it out. The Raptor also has these two little storage compartments. On one, I hold a little microfiber cloth and my disc lock and alarm, which comes in handy, so I don't have to carry it on my backpack or in my pocket. Another thing was, I replaced also the bulbs. So it has two bulbs, one on the right, one on the left. And one of them, the low beam, just burnt out. So what I end up doing is just change both of them at the same time with Bosch high quality beams. And I think the beam power increased a little bit as well. The speedometer, it is not very accurate, but I compared it with GPS on my iPhone. At 30 miles an hour, it was when it was showing 30 miles an hour, I was going about 26. At 40, it was about real speed was 35. So it's a little between 4 to 6 off. It's showing a little more than it is. But other than that, it's fine. It lags a little bit. So if you have, when you are accelerating, the needle catches up. It takes a couple seconds to catch up, and when you slow down, kind of creeps down behind. So you may think that you are still going 20, but you may be at 10 when you are slowing down. So it catches up. There is some delay. Also, the clock, it goes about 1 minute fast every week. So you have to, every couple of weeks you have to readjust it. The fuel gauge has been quite accurate, so I never ran out of gas. Even when it was very close to the empty, there was still some gas left. So they built it into the fuel tank. So there is some reserve. The mirrors look nice. They are color-coded to the body. It says that these ones are white. The only problem with my right mirror, it is a little soft. So I don't know if I can make it a little harder, but every time I go into a pothole or something, it just falls down a little bit, so I have to readjust it with my left hand while I'm riding. So I'm going to look into it, either buy a new one or just open it up and see if I can tighten it a little bit so it doesn't fall down every time I go into a pothole or speed bump. Also, I wanted to show the size difference between the Jonway Agility, my son's scooter, who is, by the way, 11 years old. He just follows me around at the side streets, although it's illegal, I know. And the Raptor. So the Raptor is good for adults. My son cannot ride this. His feet do not touch. I am 5'10", and when I come to a stop, I have to slide a little bit towards the front of the seat. The front part of the seat is a little narrower, so you can see. When I'm riding, I just push my butt a little to the back. It's very comfortable. When I'm coming to stop, I push myself forward so I can step on both soles of my feet. And many times I have carried my son on my back, no problems at all. Whereas this one is quite small, and whenever I ride it, it's a different feeling. It's very squirrely. It's not good in turns when you are leaning down. So if you are a smaller rider, just starting new, I'll say Agility may be a better choice for you. And Raptor are for people who are 5'8 and taller, I think. Otherwise, you may not be touching the ground. Okay, let me show you the size difference between the Raptor and Agility. Or I'll just go back over there. So sitting like this, I'm 5'10", both my feet reach the ground, but they are spread a little bit. So if you are much shorter than 5'10", probably it's going to start getting a little uncomfortable. But as I said, this one feels more like a small motorcycle than a scooter, so it's really nice. Because of the larger tires and wheels, you can probably see the difference side by side over here. Now on the Agility, my 11-year-old son who is filming now can easily ride this. I mean, you can see how comfortable my feet are. But then when I'm riding, I'm again 5'10", my knee starts hitting this, so I have to really push my back to the behind in order not to hit it on a speed bump or when I'm slowing down braking. So I don't know, so this will be for shorter riders, and Raptor will be very nice for taller riders. So this is my 11-year-old son, and he rides with me sometimes in the side street, and I take him to a parking lot where he practices it. This was his 11th year birthday present. Fixed it up, he likes it. And at his age, at his size, he can easily ride it and stop and then put both of his feet on the ground. Recently I visited Cruze Scooters just to take a look at the new offerings, new models. And I saw exact same Raptor, or I thought it was exact same Raptor in white, and it looked the same. Mine has the tail number YY50QT-30, and this new one, it was YN50QT-16. And when I checked the plate, the manufacturer's plate that is in that location that I'm showing right now, it had the manufacturer's Sanmen County Yongfu machine call. So I don't know if it's a different manufacturer or Jonway's has a daughter company. I don't know what it is. I have to look on the internet and see. But sometimes, you know, there are copies of copies. So with Chinese scooters, you have to be careful which manufacturer it's coming from. So I don't know anything about this Sanmen County Yongfu Machine Co. quality, but Jonway is one of the better ones in my opinion. One of the better manufacturers from China. And if you are planning to buy one, just make sure that it's really Jonway and not another manufacturer, like a knockout manufacturer. So this is part one, and I'm planning to do another one soon. But before I end this video, I'm just going to start up this so you can hear the engine. So I have not started this up for a couple days, and so it starts up easily. But because it has a big bore, my previous starter, which is located here, you know, I'm zooming on the starter. It was having problems starting the engine, especially on cold weather. So I purchased a higher torque one for about $30 from Scorpion Products. This has been good. But again, once the weather gets colder, it's September right now, it's nice and warm. Once it gets colder, we'll see if this starter is going to be any good. If not, I have to find a higher torque starter to start it up. So on the next installment, I will do a riding video so you can see this scooter when in its motion. And I will also put my iPhone over here on the straps and try to do a comparison and maximum speed I have seen 50 miles an hour on this speedometer, but it doesn't mean it was doing that. So I would like to do a top end test using the GPS, as well as a comparison of the speedometer with the GPS, the true speed. Well, I hope you have a good day and be well, and see you next time. Thank you for watching.